originally from San Antonio Block. What's your name? Demondre? Your name? What's your name?
Tyrone.
No, sure. I know you're always your homie, Ghost. What's up, homie? What's your name? Some of y'all in here now might not get that chance. You know what I'm saying? But I'm here, just like I tell my homeboys when I go to my neighborhood. You know what I'm saying? If you're my homeboy and I love you, I don't want you to go do nothing crazy. I don't want you to go catch no case or get killed. Why would I influence you to do something negative if you're supposed to be my homeboy and I'm supposed to love you? You know what I'm saying? So if your homeboys, they really love you, you know what I'm saying, they don't want you to go get in no trouble. You know what I'm saying? I know where all y'all coming from. I've been there. I was in the same situations y'all in. I was y'all age. When I was y'all age, nobody couldn't tell me nothing. It was Santana or nothing. F the world. You know what I'm saying? It was like that. But you know why it was like that? Because when I came up, Crips started in 69. I saw the gangbanging in 73. So I was, you know what I'm saying, at the end of the first generation. You know, so when I was banging, it wasn't no big homies to tell me that, you know what I'm saying, homie, don't do that, the homie, you wrong, because we always doing it. You know what I'm saying? So it wasn't nobody to be there to step in and say, don't do it. You know what I'm saying? But if y'all got some big homies that love y'all, you know what I'm saying, and if they trying to tell y'all the right thing, y'all need to do it. You know what I'm saying? Because when you hit that penitentiary, I don't care who you is, if you ain't in charge, you're going to be somebody's flunky or somebody's boy. Or whatever it is, somebody going to be there that's going to tell you what to do, and you got to do it. You know what I'm saying? If you're not the main man, if you're not running your car, then somebody else going to be running. You know what I'm saying? And whatever they tell you you got to do, you got to do it. You know what I'm saying? Especially for you, for the Zarango. You know, if you know how the protocol go, You know what I'm saying? You go in there tomorrow, you could be going home, finna go home tomorrow, and they tell you, go stick that guy. You got to go do it. If you don't do it, then you won't get stuck. Plain and simple. It's a whole lot to go with this gangbanger, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm not here to try to scare nobody or none of that because I know that don't work. You know what I'm saying? I'm just here to try to educate you a little bit, you know what I'm saying, on straightening your lives out and getting your life together. You know what I'm saying? Because all together, I done did a little bit over 25 years of my life in prison. You know what I'm saying? You know what I could have did with 25 years that I was locked up? Ain't no telling what I could have been. You know what I'm saying? But I guess that wasn't my path. But you know what I'm saying? I dedicated my life now, you know what I'm saying, to try to give back. You know what I'm saying, to help these youngsters, you know what I'm saying, that I know that I influenced to do the wrong thing. I'm trying to, you know what I'm saying, redeem myself. You know what I'm saying? So any chance I get to talk to some youngsters or try to tell them the right thing, you know what I'm saying, that's what I do.
Let me say this, G. Like a lot of us, when we growing up, we like low riders, we like cars, we like money, we like jewelry, right? Right? We like material things, right? This man had all that. When crack cocaine came out, he was the kingpin. He ain't telling y'all all the cars, all the stuff. Where's all that stuff now? Tell me where all that stuff.
Yeah, when I went to jail, the feds took it all. You know what I'm saying? They took the houses. They took like 10 cars from me. All the money I had in the bank and the safe deposit boxes. I don't even know how they found out I had money buried up in the backyard. To this day, I still don't know how they found that out. You know what I'm saying? But when they come and get you, they try to break you. You know what I'm saying? So you can't have a defense. They try to break you, you know what I'm saying, mentally, you know what I'm saying, and financially, and they try to lock you up forever. You know what I'm saying? But that, you know, that's in the drug game, in the drug world, but even in the gang world. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be like, I'm gonna tell y'all one thing that y'all really need to know. Respect is everything, man. You know what I'm saying? You can't go around just disrespecting people, you know what I'm saying? It's like this with me. I respect every man, you know what I'm saying, until he showed me different. You know what I'm saying? Because it don't matter if he weaker than he weak. I feel he weak. It don't matter if I feel he a square or I feel he a buster because he don't bang. That don't matter, man. You have to respect every man because you don't know what's in a man's heart. You know what I'm saying? I done seen plenty of gangsters and real dudes get killed by busters because they underestimate them. You know what I'm saying? And anytime you hit a dude up and be like, where you from? You know, that's a form of aggression. Because I know when I was banging, if a fool hit me up and asked me, well, I'm going to be like, you know, excuse my friends, but nigga, where you from? Fuck you mean where I'm from? You know what I'm saying? That's just the way that we react to that. So, you know what I'm saying? It would have been different if I would have walked up to you and been like, hey, what's up, homie? My name's G. I'm from Santana. Where you from, homie? You know, that's a different thing. But when you come at somebody like that with aggression, automatically he gonna respond with aggression. And automatically it's on, bam. Because he felt like you disrespected him. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's that's the way it is. You know what I'm saying? So when you sweating people like that, oppressing on people like that, you got to expect that it's gonna be some repercussions. You know what I'm saying? And you actually creating an enemy that didn't even have to be your enemy. You know what I'm saying? You creating an enemy. You know what I'm saying? That's why you just can't go around. You got respect. Like I said, respect is everything, man. If you don't have no respect for people, you ain't gonna make it. Because I don't care how tough you is, you're gonna run into somebody that ain't gonna give a damn just like you. You know what I'm saying? So I advise everybody to at least be respectful. You know what I'm saying? Because that's why ain't no man gonna go for disrespect. Especially y'all young hotheads. You know what I'm saying? If I walked up to him and he don't know me off the front, I'm like, nigga, where you from, homie? Look at it, you know, this aggression. You gonna be like, nigga, where you from? 9-0, whatever. You know, you gonna bang on me back. And then when you bang on me, I'm gonna feel a certain type of way. We gonna end up getting into a conflict. a conflict that didn't even have to happen. You know, especially when y'all in this school setting. You know what I'm saying? This school is to come here to learn, homie. You know what I'm saying? For real, for real. You know what I'm saying? You here for one purpose only. You know what I'm saying? That's to get your education, get your diploma. You know what I'm saying? So you can go out there into the world and hopefully get into junior college or something. Because I'm going to tell you right now, homie, the dope game is a wrap. Gang banging, it's a wrap. Everybody, you know what I'm saying? You youngsters are still out there. You know what I'm saying? But most of the older guys, the OGs, BGs, TGs, they already know it's a wrap, man. They just letting y'all do y'all thing. But if your homies really care about you, they'll tell you, homie, this ain't the life. You know what I'm saying? I did 25 years of my life in prison, man. I really should have been on a mountain somewhere in a mansion in a yacht. You know what I'm saying? I could have been. Who knows? You know what I'm saying? But I deprived myself of that because, you know what I'm saying, I was doing crazy things. You know, I was disrespectful. I was disrespectful for real, man. That's why I'm lucky I'm still here. You know? But I learned, though. You live and you learn. When you live long enough, you really gonna learn some stuff, man. And don't just take what I'm saying and let it go in one ear and out the other, homie. Because I'm telling y'all, I really do care about y'all. And I don't want y'all to get caught up the way I got caught up, man. And that's real. You know what I'm saying? You gotta be thinking of, the main thing is thinking about your future. You know what I'm saying? And in order, but when you think about your future, you got to put a game plan down and write down the steps you're going to have to take to get to your goal. You know what I'm saying? And this right now. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to have to, I'm 56 years old. You know what I'm saying? By the time you're 30, 35, 30, you should have your own home and everything. You know what I'm saying? You shouldn't have to worry about that. You know, I go in my neighborhood and I talk to my homies and I kick it with my homies because I love them. You know what I'm saying? But I don't live in the hood no more. But I go through there all the time. And when I pull up on them, I let them know. You still out here on the street. I got homies my age, man, that's still on the street doing the same thing with nothing. You know what I'm saying? By the time you get this age, you want to be just retired, homie. You know what I'm saying? Living your life, going on cruises, enjoying your grandkids and your family. You know? And for y'all that be sagging, when I was y'all age, I used to sag. But I used to just, if a mini sag, I ain't had my pants way down here to where you see in my ass. You know, I'm some real tall, homie. You know what I'm saying?
So let me ask you this, because a lot of people that don't know, they say that started in prison. I've been in prison.
I'm going to tell y'all.
I ain't never seen nobody in prison.
I'm going to tell y'all something, homie. That ain't got nothing to do. That's some crap somebody made up.
Exactly.
That ain't got nothing to do with prison. I got a homeboy, well, supposed to be a piece of crap, but an ex-homie. His name is Sag. And he had that name since the 70s. Because he sagged all the time. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, that didn't come from prison. That came from Crips on the streets. That didn't come from prison, period. You know, but at the end of the day, I'm going to tell you, I'll be really embarrassed, man, when I see y'all youngsters out there with your pants way down, brown hair, you see all your drawers in your butt. You know what I mean? Ain't nothing fly about that. You know, I can see if you just sagging a little bit, you know what I'm saying, okay, but when your pants is way down here, when you got to have your whole, keep your legs open, you're just going to fall, you know what I'm saying, that's crazy. You know, I like to present myself, I like to be presentable all the time, you know what I'm saying, and every one of y'all young men and young ladies in here, you should want to present yourself, you know what I'm saying, to your best ability at your own, at all the time. You ain't gonna go in no job trying to get no job with your pants sagged. That ain't gonna happen. You know what I'm saying? So when you walk in the door, it's a no. You know what I'm saying? You have to be presentable. You know what I'm saying? Because it represents you and who you are. It's a reflection of you. People you don't even have to open your mouth. But if you go in there with your pants sagging, they ain't gonna even give you a chance to open your mouth. You know what I'm saying? Because they look at you and how you dress, and they just stereotype automatically. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, automatically, you're not gonna get the job. You know what I'm saying? So, for those, you know, I understand why y'all do it, because it's the thing to do. A lot of the youngsters, most of the youngsters do it. But at the end of the day, you're not representing yourself to the fullest of your ability. You know what I'm saying? You're not really showing pride in how you dress and how you carry yourself. You know what I'm saying? People look at all that. That's why when they look at you, they don't even say nothing. They just judge you before you can even open your mouth, just because of the way you dress and the way you look. You know what I'm saying? But you can't blame them, because they see a lot of people like that doing a whole lot of negative stuff. So they just throw you in that category with them. You know what I'm saying? And it is what it is. You know, but at the end of the day, man, I love all y'all. I know I don't know y'all. You know what I'm saying? But all y'all are my brothers and sisters. You know? And, you know, I wouldn't mind, you know, having a one-on-one with all y'all so I can really get to know y'all. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, man, people think that you guys is gang bang. They think you just woke up one day and said, I want a gang bang F the world. But I've been there. I know that it's different reasons and different circumstances that guys start gang bang. You know what I'm saying? There's a whole lot of reasons. Don't nobody just wake up and want to bang. You could feel neglected. It could be peer pressure, a mental abuse, physical abuse, all kinds of different things why you start gang bang. I started gang banging because I tried to fill a void in my heart because my father wasn't there. But I didn't even realize that until I was like 37, 38 years old, laying up in a prison cell, just laying on my bunk thinking, reevaluating my life. You know what I'm saying? It's a whole lot of unresolved trauma, you know what I'm saying, that went on in our lives, you know what I'm saying, that we haven't dealt with yet. You know, so at the end of the day, man, let's think about what I'm saying. You know, I can't make nobody do nothing. All I can do is just, you know, keep it 100. I'm always keeping 100 with you. You know what I'm saying? No matter what. You know, whether it's hard or not, I'm gonna keep it 100. You know what I'm saying? And I just want y'all to do y'all thing. But just remember, man, respect is everything. You know what I'm saying? Just like you don't want nobody to disrespect you, don't disrespect the next man. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing wrong, because when I was growing up, it was unheard of us disrespecting teachers and all that. You know what I'm saying? Because they just here to help us. They trying to get us to where we need to be. So you know what I'm saying? You should always respect, you know what I'm saying, people with authority. You know what I'm saying? Whether you want to or not, just do it off the rip. You know what I'm saying? Because they here to help. You know, we all know about the police and how they are. You know what I'm saying? But even with them, at times you have to respect them, because your life is basically in danger. Because we know they kill minorities that are long and rape for nothing. You know what I'm saying? Every time they have a mass shooting, and it's a white boy, how do they just automatically just go and arrest him with no problems, you know, without shooting him, without even beating him, without even whooping his butt? But they killing, you know what I'm saying, blacks and Hispanics for that's unarmed. You know what I'm saying? So when it comes to the police, man, even though we know they're a piece of crap, you still have to be respectful, man. Just do what you got to do and get up out of there. You know what I'm saying? Because they don't, damn man, they don't mind killing us. You know what I'm saying? We're just another statistic. We're another notch on their belt. Because most of these police departments, all of them have little gangs inside of the department, little racist gangs. You know what I'm saying? So even though when you know they wrong, don't even trip. If you can record it, record it. But at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? You're just trying to get away with your life. You know what I'm saying? You're just trying to live to see another day. You know, it's just like right now, you know, in Compton, you know, they got a thing called CC Rogers, Compton Crip Rogers. You know what I'm saying? all the Christian comes are trying to come together and squash all these beefs with each other. You know what I'm saying? So we've been having meetings for like the last month. We got another meeting on Saturday. You know what I'm saying? And the gang, they're actually squashing their beefs. You know what I'm saying? Because the shit is crazy, man. You know what I'm saying? Who want to ride around looking behind their back every day, all day? You know what I'm saying? Oh, I can't go over here because I don't get along with this gang. I can't go over here because I don't get along with this gang. At the end of the day, when it's peace, it's more everything. You know what I'm saying? More money, more women, more everything when it's peace. You know what I'm saying? Everybody just want peace. You know what I'm saying? When I was growing up, I didn't go nowhere without my pistol. You know what I'm saying? Nowhere. You know what I'm saying? But that put me in prison I went to jail in 1985 for a murder, though. You know what I'm saying? A murder that I didn't even do, for real. My homie did it, but I was there. And I wouldn't tell on him. I rode the beat. You know what I'm saying? That's how much I love my neighborhood. You know what I'm saying? But now when I look back, and all the homies that I know that died, I got over at least almost 150 homies that they got killed. When I look back at all my homies that done died, all the stuff that I done went through, everything that I done sacrificed for my neighborhood, I'm going to love my neighborhood forever. You know what I'm saying? I'm always beef with my neighborhood, but I'm not a gang member. You know? At the end of the day, I look at it like it was for nothing. You know what I'm saying? I look at it like everything I did was for nothing. You know what I'm saying? But it brought me to this point to where I am today, to where I can talk to y'all, you know, so I don't feel too bad about it, you know what I'm saying, because now I can help. I'm in a position, you know what I'm saying, to give back. You know, but, you know, that's my story, man. But at the end of the day, I want to get to know all y'all one-on-one so, you know, we can talk. You know what I'm saying? Because I know that big homies lead homies in the wrong direction. Not even big homies, just homies your age that might feel they got more authority than you, or lead you in the wrong direction. You gotta be man enough to step up and say, homie, I'm not with that. Homie, I don't wanna do that. Homie, I'm not gonna do that. You know what I'm saying? You hold your own destiny. Don't let nobody drive you into no brick wall. You know what I'm saying? If you know it's wrong and you feel you don't wanna do it, man, just say no. It don't matter about what they say or what they think. Man, just tell them, homie, I'm not going to do it. You know what I'm saying? Because, man, they'll drive you straight into a brick wall, man. I'm just fortunate. You know what I'm saying? Because when I grew up, when I came up, every jail I've been in, every penitentiary I've been in, I was always the one in control. I always ran the car. I ran the car because I didn't want nobody else to run me into no brick wall. You know? And you always got dummies in there that's going to put the car in jeopardy. Some dummy might go steal something. That's a problem. Some dummy might go gamble on his butt. That's a problem. Some dummy might go get some drugs and owe something. You know what I'm saying? But every time, you always got to deal with that. That's a whole lot of stuff that go on in them prisons, man. A whole lot of stuff. But like I say, if you ain't in charge, then you just another one in line. You know, you want to take control of your life, homie. You want to do what you want to do. You don't want nobody else to be able to guide your life. Because at the end of the day, when you sitting up in that cell, it's just you. You know, at this day and age, homies ain't going to look out for you. You know what I'm saying? And another thing that why almost every neighborhood is messed up is because you got these guys that's claiming the hood that didn't even grow up in the hood, so they don't love the hood like you do. They didn't grow up with you, so they don't love you. You know, when I grew up with all my homies, we grew up together. You got dudes, you know what I'm saying, claiming Compton from, like, you got rappers claiming, you. Man, you got Chris Brown claiming Fruit Town. You got Soulja Boy claiming Fruit Town. Lil Bow Wow claiming Fruit Town. Come on, man, stop it. Ain't none of y'all even California. You know, y'all can't love the hood because you're not doing nothing for the hood. Y'all just claiming the hood so y'all can get clout and y'all can have more blood to buy y'all records because y'all claiming blood. That's all that is. You know what I'm saying? YG, he ain't really from Compton. YG from Paramount. A lot of these guys, I know all about all these cats, man. Especially anything got to do with Compton. You know what I'm saying? But they using the gangs to sell more records. You know what I'm saying? If I'm claiming blood, and I'm making music, saying blood in it and this and that, and you a blood, you gonna buy it. You gonna buy it. If I'm a Crip and the homies out of Crip, I'm gonna buy it. They know what they're doing, but at the end of the day, they tricking the gangsters. You got busters tricking the gangsters and using the gangsters so they can get clout, they can get more money, and these dudes don't even realize it. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, it is what it is. You know, but like I said, if y'all don't take nothing else from what I said, man, just remember respect. You know what I'm saying? Respect can save your life. And that's real. Just remember respect. Peace.
Y'all got any questions for me?
State Penitentiary. I was in Folsom. I was in Donovan. I was in Tehachapi. I was in, going off the 10 going toward Arizona. I was in the feds, I was in Victorville, I was in Atlanta, and I was in Pennsylvania. Penitentiaries, not no camps or no, you know what I'm saying, level twos or level ones, straight behind the wall penitentiaries where dudes get killed on the regular. One thing about jail, man, jail, it ain't, when I first started going to jail, it was something like a little vacation fun. Now, it's punishment. It ain't nothing like it used to be in the 80s and the 90s. It's real punishment now.
And like you said, it's like the reputation we have on these streets, when you go to prison, that don't mean nothing. You got to start over, because there's been dudes there that have been in there all they lives. And there ain't no guns in there. You're gonna have to make a knife, you're gonna have to come from here. It ain't like out here. It's totally different. And then people like he said, if you let somebody dictate your life, right, if you don't stand up for your own life or make your own decision, somebody in there, one of your homies, is gonna tell you to do something that you don't wanna do, you're gonna mess up. But imagine somebody in there not represent, not being there to really keep the violence down. If somebody's in there and said, if I come in the pen and he's running this, right, and he don't really like me, he got control of my life. And the easy way to do it, they say I'm snitching or whatever, right? What's gonna happen, Jim?
Man, you got a whole lot of guys in there that even got messed over just because of personal beef. Dudes ain't really did nothing, but just because I don't like him, I feel a certain kind of way about him, and I got the power. You know what I'm saying? Man, go blast that fool. Get him, you know what I'm saying? It's crazy. You know what I'm saying? When you go up in there, you know what I'm saying, you got to be real particular, real, man, real cautious about what you do, what you say, and how you represent yourself. Because it's a gang, it's a whole lot of guys that got stabbed and killed just because somebody didn't like them personally. They ain't even do nothing wrong. It's just personal beef. You know what I'm saying? They followed them from the streets to the prison.
Well, hold on. I heard you got personal beef, like, you know, it's good. You're supposed to, like, fight it out or, like, get permission.
If I'm running, and you come up in there, I ain't got to tell nobody that I got a personal beef with you. All I got to do is tell the fools that's up under me to get you. You know what I'm saying? And they gonna get you. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, at the end of the day, it depends on who you are. You know what I'm saying? But it does happen. It's just more politics in the penitentiary. You know, penitentiary is full of politics. You know, county jail, you just in there waiting to go to the penitentiary. You know, yeah, that's different. The county jail was vicious. Back when I was in there, when they had the Crip and the Blood module, 4,800 was the Crip module, 3,800 was the Blood module. You come up in that Crip module, and you're not who you say you are. Well, I've been laying in my cell and heard plenty of guys getting raped and some more stuff. Yes. You know, so I'm serious.
That's real.
You know,
Not only that, I've heard people come up to me and say, "I'm not a gangster. I'm not a real gangster, right?" You know, you see people out here, you think they real. When you get up in there, it's like I had this one individual who came in, he said that, and I said, "Look, don't say that too loud, because if somebody else hear you say that, they're going to really punk you or do something." Not knowing that he was trying to reach out for help. He went back to his cell and hung himself. I should have told him to go PC or something. He probably would have still been alive. But he's just one of many other people that hung himself, got raped, because you ain't from where you say you from. And paperwork, huh?
They do that because they fucking freaks in here. You know, sick in the head.
Okay, I thought one had to do with the other.
That's just their excuse.
Oh, okay.
That's just
their
excuse.
You can't afford the tickets.
That's just their excuse. And pulling guns out, but when you hit that county jail, you're gonna get a face. You're gonna run into some of your enemies. You know what I'm saying? And you definitely better know how to fight. You know what I'm saying? Because you're gonna get a face. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody, ain't no gun. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna have to fight. I know plenty of people went in there and punked out. That was trigger happy on the street.
Okay, gotcha.
When they got up in there and they had no pistol, you know what I'm saying? They pumped out. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna run into your enemies. Whether it's county jail, wayside, twin.